What do you need now?
I've already apologized. What more do you want? Unless you're looking for another nibble. No innocence. You have my word. Only villains that we need to kill anyway. After all, you know what I am now. I can fight with all my weapons, teeth included. And if I happen to drain the occasional bandit during a fight, what's the harm? They're just as dead. As am I. I'm starting to feel a little peckish already. It's simple. Just find a vampire that will drink your blood and turn you into a vampire spawn. Their obedient puppet. In theory, the next step is to drink their blood. Once you've done that, you're free. And a true vampire. Yes and no. The problem is, once you're a vampire spawn, they completely control you. They have to allow you to bite them. And why would they do that? Vampires are power-hungry creatures. They won't lose a servant to create a competitor. Trust me, it doesn't happen. Why do you insist on exhuming the past?
I was a slave. A vampire spawn. Kept by the Tsar family. Perhaps I still am.
I was never able to resist their commands.
But now, I've been conveniently lost. They won't ever control me again.
I won't lie. It's tempting.
If I keep the tadpole, I risk transforming into a grotesque monster. If I lose the tadpole, Cazador has control of me, body and soul, and I return to the shadows. It's grim either way. So why not sell what's left of my soul to a devil? Better he has it than Cazador. You're familiar with the phrase, better the devil you know. I know Cazador, and I'll take anything that saves me from that. And clearly the tadpole. If we can't understand it, we'll never control it. And I'm not about to hand control of my life from a vampire lord to those slimy, grey beasts.